Okay, this is the second video, and these are questions that I will answer. But it's like a retroactive reverse engineer. Okay, this is a reverse engineer. Okay, retroactive reverse engineer. So if you have these questions and you plan to take medicine proper, you watch this video. Okay, this is the video you need to watch. Okay, my answers will be based on medicine proper of long ago in the olden days. Okay, it is not medicine proper in 2023, medicine proper in the olden days. Okay, so that's my answer. Okay, you watch this video if you want, if you plan to be in medicine proper, if you plan to take up and be a doctor, be a physician. Okay, so here are the answers, reverse engineer. Okay, from the point of view of a doctor, licensed doctor, and we will reverse engineer it, answer it for the past. Okay, what does your dream life look like? What does your dream life look like? The present. Oh, by the way, the context here, context, C-O-N-T-E-X-T, the context here is medicine proper of long ago, years ago, too long years ago, many, many long years ago, and the work conditions here in the Philippines. Okay? Work conditions here in the Philippines. Okay? And I am not a, what you call, a medical specialist. You could call me as a medical generalist. In short, general practitioner. Okay? General practitioner, GP, GP physician, GP doctor. Okay? I'm not a specialist. Okay? Probably with some knowledge in occupational health and safety. Okay? So, what does your dream life look like? Dream life look like? So, reverse engineer, answer. After passing the board, you are easily hired. Take note, the context is here in the Philippines. You are easily hired, H-I-R-E-D, easily hired. You get hired quickly, okay? Remember, I'm not a specialist, okay? You get easily hired and of long ago, from an insider, my salary then was lower than my company driver. My salary, entry level salary, was lower than my company driver. The driver straight talking. The salary of mine as a doctor was lower than the salary of a company driver. I think he didn't finish fourth year high school, or probably never took up first year college. Company driver, high school graduate, or less, but was in the company for 20 or more years, 20 or more years. Okay? His salary was larger than mine. Take note, I am a licensed doctor of medicine. Okay, so dream life? So that's the answer. Okay? If after passing the board exams, you plan to take on residency, then you have to have three studies. We call that number one, first year case study, prospective and retrospective study. Okay? So those case studies would probably cost you. Remember, I'm never a specialist, so I didn't get to do those three studies. Okay? But you would again shell out your money. And the salary is not enough to pay for the studies, three studies, which are requirements to pass each and every year. You have to do those studies to pass. Okay? So those are the most common options, being a generalist and going to specialty medicine residency. Okay? It's all here in the Philippines. The context is here is all here in the Philippines only. Okay? Number two question, what does your ideal week or day look like? Ideal week or day look like? So, probably fourth year medicine, I'll just tell you. Fourth year medicine, every day you go to the hospital. Every 3 days you're on duty, 24 hours on duty. It's rare that you get to sleep, okay? For the 24 hours duty, okay? And it's work, work, work. And if you are not studying, remember, it's fourth year medicine and after 2 years you'll take the board exams. Okay? So you have to study again. Okay? So if you're not on duty, you come out, you go there at 7 and you come home at time out at 5. Come home at 7 or 8 in the evening. Okay? So that's it. That's for 1 whole year. Fourth year medicine, 1 whole year. PGI, 1 whole year. Of course, after passing the board exams, you only have to work 8 hours. Okay? 8 hours. That was the topic about the company driver. Okay? I worked for 8 hours each and every day. Saturday, I think it was 8 to 12. Okay? 8 to 12. So my only day off was Sunday. Unfortunately, I have to wake up at 4:30 a.m. to get a bus so that around 6:15 I'll be at the office because the time in is 7 o'clock. And here in the Philippines, if you got out late, you'll be caught by traffic and you'll be late for the office. Okay? So what sort of work would you like to be doing? What sort of work you would you like to be doing? So that's the kind of work that we call that checkup. Ask the patient what's the problem and do diagnostic tests like that. That would be every day, 8 hours a day. Okay? If you're not on duty. If you're on duty, that's 24 hours. You'll be doing that same routine. Asking the patient what's the problem and doing diagnostic exams. On rare occasions, you will be asked to take out poop, POOPO, very rare occasion. Once a year, probably. Okay, take out poop, POOP. And not so rare occasions, you would see blood spurting out and squirting out in front of your face. Really squirting out and, okay, blood in your face. You have to go with that if you plan to be a doctor. It's part of your life, okay? So number four, when would you like to come home? You have no choice. There are 8 hours of work, except aside from that 24 hours. Where would you like to live? Probably you cannot say, but that time, you have to take residency and pass the board exams, second board exams for residency. That's a medical specialist training, residency. You have to pass the second board exam. If you pass that, It's the start of a good life, financially. Okay? That's where you would like, where you would choose to live, L-I-V-E. You can choose to live at the place that you like, because you're now living comfortably. Before that, money's a problem. It's only in the Philippines, okay? How long do you want your commute to be? Just as I told you, first year, second year, third year medicine, and the fourth year, and the PGI, I have to wake up at around 4:30 a.m. be on a jeep or on a bus at around past 5, okay? So that I can be in the office or at school 5:45 a.m., 6 o'clock, okay? So, obviously, in no hurry to go to school, okay? We call that your calm down. C-A-L-M-E-D, calm down already. Okay? I don't want to go to school with 1 second remaining. Okay? That's a lot of stress. So that's the commute. How long commute? Okay? What sort of people would you like to work with? Now, this is an interesting question. Okay? For the first 3 years, all you will be confronted with are professors and laboratory people, okay? The one manning the laboratories, the anatomy laboratory, okay? The gross anatomy laboratory and other chemicals laboratory like that. So that's the first 3 years. The fourth year, that's where surprises come up, okay? Now, I'll tell you about me, myself, and I. I'm a person that, for example, 100 persons out there, okay? 100 persons, and those persons, 100 persons, are grouping up into 520 people, okay? 5 groups of 20, so it's 100. And those 5 groups are not liking each other very much, okay? So, I am that kind of person who are friends with all the groups, okay? Friends with all the groups, and friends with the 100 people. I'm that person, okay? I want to be friends with everyone, okay? Now, I told you what sort of people would you like to work with, because in the hospital, there are also groups like that, okay? Groups in conflict like that, in quotation marks, groups in conflict, groups that don't like you, okay? And I see the conflict commonly in doctor, nurse, nurse, doctor. So sometimes they clash. We call that class of personalities. Clash of personalities. Okay. Probably some doctors are probably that high like that. And they think lowly of the nurse. Probably, okay? So that's where the clashes come. Okay? There are some exceptions, okay? So that's where personalities clash. So, because in the hospital, there's a sort of ranking. Doctors are ranked higher than nurses, like that. Sort of imaginary rank, okay? And sometimes doctors are too proud like that in some situations, and they have a clash with the nurses, okay? Me, I never had clashes with anyone, okay? Okay, so that would be a minor problem, sort of people who would you like to work with. Okay, minor problem. Sort of people who would you like to work with? Probably. One exception to this question, probably is sometimes a patient questions you on your diagnosis, okay? Your manner of treating, okay? So probably that's the exception. Doctor to patient, patient to doctor, probably a clash, okay? And that's also rare. Okay, so the questions are complete, and subscribe and follow, follow and subscribe. I saw these questions and it's nice to reverse engineer from the point of view of a past doctor. Okay? So you now know the answers to these questions. Okay? Subscribe and follow, follow and subscribe.